Good morning, Gulf High. Today is Monday, April 9th, 2018. I'm Skylar Tanner.
And I'm Lizzie Ann Wajika, coming to you from WBUC Studios with today's school news.
The word of the day today is recrimination, an adjective meaning counter-accusation. Can you use that in a sentence, Leslie Ann?
Anytime, Skylar. The burglar had the nerve to express recriminations against the homeowner for hitting him with a shovel.
For lunch today, we'll be having PB&J, turkey caprese sandwich, teriyaki beef nuggets, brown rice, vegetable rice roll, salad bar, and pizza.
And now for today's weather forecast.
Today's weather forecast includes a high of 82 degrees and a low of 70 with a 30% chance of rainfall. Enjoy the weather, Bucks.
In 1939, Italy invades Albania.
In 1770, William Wordsworth is born.
Here's some strange news, Bucks.
Police in Ohio investigating reports of zombie-like raccoons.
Cat in England stays in tree for 3 days, refusing rescue.
By now, everyone should have a better understanding about the options available to help you survive if there's ever an act of violence on campus using the ABC strategy: alert and avoid, barricade and counter. As you continue to learn more about the active threat plan, we will continue to practice and conduct drills on only one component of the ABC strategy at a time. In the first semester, your drills focus on the new barricading strategy and properly locking down. The second semester drill will focus on evacuation or avoiding an active threat. It is very unlikely that everyone would need to evacuate from your school at the same time if there was an active threat. However, during your drill, everyone will have the opportunity to learn more about avoiding a threat and practice finding a safe hiding place. First, let's review what it means to evacuate from an active threat. To evacuate means to move away from a place of immediate danger as quickly as possible to a safer place where you can hide until the threat no longer exists and help arrives. Evacuation in order to avoid danger is a lot different from what you're used to doing when you evacuate during a fire drill. Avoiding danger does not always mean you will go outside. It just means running away from immediate danger to a safer place. Here are some examples of how or when an evacuation may be a good choice if ever faced with a life-threatening situation. Evacuation from a hallway or a common area to a nearby classroom that could be secured from inside and locked or barricaded. Evacuation from a cafeteria where a lockdown is not possible into a safer room that could be secured from the inside, or you may need to leave the building entirely to get to safety. Evacuation from a gymnasium where a lockdown is not possible into a safer room that can be secured from the inside, or you may need to actually leave the gym entirely to get to safety. Evacuation from an athletic field, playground, or exterior common area, or any other outdoor location to a farther outdoor location or completely off campus. Evacuation from a classroom or a pod into another room that can be secured from the inside, or having to go outside the building entirely to get to safety. This may be your best choice if a dangerous intruder suddenly entered the same classroom where you were at. Knowing where to go when running away from a threat is as important as knowing when to go. Finding a place where you are out of sight is important. We sometimes call this concealment or camouflage. However, you will also want to find a place that can protect you from physical injury if possible. We sometimes call this solid cover. Here are some examples of each. Concealment may hide you, but may not always protect you. Shrubbery, plants, tall grass, wooden fences, plastic, anything that has a hollow core. Cover can help keep you safe from physical harm. Parked cars or buses near the motor or a wheel. Concrete walls, other solid buildings, large trees, or even a telephone pole. Remember these important things about an evacuation. You should not leave a relatively safe space for the vast unknown. The decision to evacuate is based on where the violence is happening. If there is an active shooter or violent attacker on campus, you should only evacuate if the location of the attacker is known and there is an exit that is easy to get to and will allow you to reach safety while avoiding the attacker. Avoid gathering together in large groups in wide open spaces. Leave your personal belongings behind. They slow you down. Running is okay. In fact, it is preferred in a life-threatening situation. However, during your drills, we will walk to avoid possible injury to students and staff. Avoid elevators and escalators. Alert and take others to safety with you, but do not stay behind because others refuse to go. Call 911 when it is safe to do so. Students should tell a responsible adult where they are when it is safe to do so. If evacuation or escape is necessary, you should try to do so by any means that you can. In a life-threatening situation, any path that can get you to safety is okay. Here are some examples. Exit doors, fire doors, or emergency exits. Breaking a window and escaping through a window if it is safe to do so. Restricted areas normally only used by school staff. You will likely meet arriving police officers or sheriff's deputies during an incident like this. Students and staff should display empty hands with open palms, keeping your hands up near your head, and always obey the instructions of arriving police. Should you come across a weapon that was dropped by the attacker, do not pick it up or handle the weapon. It is impossible to predict when or where a dangerous threat will occur. That is why it is important to think about possible evacuation locations on your campus. Be informed, be prepared, and be safe. The goal is survival. Get away from immediate danger as quickly as possible. Spread out, get out of sight, hide. Find cover if you can, get low, and get quiet.
Hey Skylar, what do you call a singing computer?
A dome.
You are invited to student parent night on April 19th at 5 in the cafeteria, as we work together to create a collaborative approach to bullying prevention and awareness. Dinner will be served from 5 to 5:30. We hope to see you there.
Next Thursday is the last blood drive of the year. It will be 8 a.m. through 1 p.m. and you must be 16 years old to donate. See Ms. Butler in room 107 or pick up your permission slip during AMB lunches.
For more information, please refer to the scroller.
That's all for our news.
Have a great National Chicken Little Awareness Day, Bucks.
I know it's here. There's a piece of the sky somewhere on the ground here. It was shaped like that.
It looks like a stop sign.